Good morning. Today we're going to look at how to ship a guitar, to pack it and document the condition so that you could avoid any problems should it become missing or damaged during shipment. I will usually make a demo video prior to sending something out, showing all the dials, knobs, pickups working, me playing it. Then I'll go over the body, the neck, make sure everything shows, and if there are any flaws or imperfections, I point that out. I want to give them every possible look at the instrument that I can to make sure I'm fairly and accurately documenting it. Photograph your instrument from every angle. You want to show every detail, especially the areas that get handled more, like where the chords plug in, where the pickups are, where you're going to be using the fretboard, where you're going to be strumming. All of those things, you want to give extra attention to the details on it. And here are some of the pictures that I used in this case. And you can see the imperfections. I've made sure that those are very clear, where they are and how extreme or not they are. I want to show there are no blemishes on the other areas, the headstock, the dials, the controls, so show no signs of wear and tear. And for packing, I keep my old boxes, and when I'm packing something like this, I'll make my own box. I did some research, and according to artisan.com, they were suggesting that the best thing to do inside your case, you want to make sure there are no open areas. So I'm filling all those areas with cotton cloths. They also suggested some areas said to loosen the strings, some said not to. So I compromised and loosened them somewhat. And also I'm putting cotton cardboard in between the strings and the body and the neck. Make sure that's protected. And inside the case, I want to make sure there are no holes. And I'm going to wrap the headstock as well with a cotton rag to make sure that's well protected. I'm stuffing the holes between the case and the guitar with cotton rags so that the guitar doesn't shift. These cases are really nice cases. This probably isn't necessary, but hey, it couldn't hurt. And you're thinking too, if you're shipping this instrument or any instrument, they are usually not very careful with how they handle things. And I'm thinking this thing's going to get shuffled around, thrown, so I want to take care for that. Another thing to be aware of that you wouldn't necessarily think of, when you're shipping your instrument, it's going to go through different weather zones. So you want to try to protect your instrument against the weather and the elements, extreme hot and cold. I'm wrapping bubble wrap around this in addition to buffering the neck, which is usually an area that tends to get jarred and broken. I'm going to wrap the whole thing so it's protected against the elements, the extreme heat and cold. Tape it up, make sure it's weather tight as well. Now I'm going to seal this in heavy lawn bags. These are incredibly heavy. So what I'm going to do is encase the guitar. I've got large ones. I'm going to go ahead and wrap the bottom, seal it up. And then I'll do the same thing with the top and make sure it's really sealed. And this, again, will protect against moisture and any severe temperature changes. As you know, temperature and moisture can crack the body of your guitar and ruin your pickups. It can do a lot of damage. So the bottom's been sealed. Now I'm going to go ahead and seal the top portion, tape it up with packing tape to make sure it's very secure. My first layer of boxing, it's going to be a guitar box with all the packing and the bubble wrap that I have around this guitar. It doesn't quite fit, so I went ahead and sliced the side, and I'll be fitting this box to fit this guitar. and I have a lot of other heavy boxes, and I'll just keep wrapping the guitar with the boxes, cutting and shaping them as I go. Here I'm stuffing the box anywhere where the guitar might have a tendency to shuffle, especially in the neck area. I'm making sure that the guitar is very snug and it's not going to shift around during transport. When shipping instruments, a real common thing is that they get stacked and it usually will damage the instrument. So in addition to that, I'm going to make sure I have very heavy cardboard protecting the top and the bottom. And my box is just about ready to be taped up. I'm using heavy-duty packing tape. I'm making sure this box is real secure. I'm wrapping the heavy packing tape around the body so that it doesn't come apart in transit. Now I'm ready to start making the exterior boxes for this. And what I'm going to do is just kind of lay it down. I opened up the boxes and I'm just going to kind of bend them into shape and then tape them up. And you can kind of do this like you do drywall, just kind of score the side. And right here you can see I'm going to go ahead and score the side and then bend it into place. And again, I'm making sure everything's real secure with the packing tape. I'm wrapping everything up. You know, it's better to have overkill than to have something happen because you didn't properly pack it. I know this is overkill, but I don't want anything to happen to this guitar before it gets to its destination. I was told that FedEx offers the best insurance and is easier to collect if something happens than the other carriers. And I'm just going round and round and round, making sure all the edges are sealed. Okay, the guitar is all packed, ready to go. I packed it really good. They said to mark it so that the top and the bottom were on the sides so that they wouldn't stack on top of the belly, which I did. I packed the case with soft cotton rags so that it wouldn't shift around, not that it does anyway, but, and then I put the case wrapped in bubble wrap, then I put heavy plastic lawn bags around it, and then I put that inside of a guitar box, and then in addition to that, I wrapped that with heavy boxes, and then I wrapped it once again with heavy garbage bags and marked it with fragile. So I'm gonna send it FedEx and it should be good. I mean, it's weatherproof. It's got bubble wrap, wrapped in bubble wrap, heavy cardboard. So I feel confident that this will make it to its destination without any harm. If you enjoyed this video, please share, like, and subscribe. And I will see you next week with a different topic. So go out and make some music.